Christ speaking.
奉耶稣基督圣名说话。
Peace to our brothers and sisters here tonight.
愿在座的各位弟兄姊妹平安。
I'm going to continue with our study on the book of Jude.
我们今天晚上要继续查考犹大书里面的信息。
We know that this book is about defending the faith.
我们知道这个书信是有关于这个捍卫我们的信仰。
And we also see that here, Jude was inspired by God to discuss the works of the false prophets in great details.
那这个犹大被圣灵来启示、来感动，谈到这些假先知的工作，非常详细的提到他们的工作。
Whatever is stated in the book actually will occur in the end time true church as well.
这本书信所提到的所有的事情，在末世的真教会都会一一的发生。
The messages here are not only for the people then, but at the time, but also for us.
那个犹大书里面的信息不单只是给犹大那个时候的信徒，也是给我们末世的真教会的信徒。
We mentioned that Satan would make use of people to go against God.
我们有提过，撒旦会利用人来阻挡神的工。
To speak against the church, to speak against the authority of the church.
来毁谤教会，来攻击教会，来毁谤这些教会的权柄。
And also to speak against God and to speak against His truth.
要抵挡这个真神跟抵挡这个真理。
I want you to turn back to look at verse 16 again.
我们再回来看犹大书的十六节。
Mentioned about the nature of the false teachers.
这里讲到这些假师傅的他们品性。
Here we are told that they are grumblers, complainers.
他们是常常发怨言、私下议论的人。
So walk according to their own lusts, and their mouth great swelling words.Flattering people to gain advantage.
他们是随从自己的情欲而行，口中说夸大话，为得便宜谄媚人。
If you read verse 10,
我们如果念第十节
，here it says they speak evil or whatever they do not know.
这些人诽谤回他们所不知道的。
In verse 8, it says they speak evil of dignitaries.
这里讲他们是轻慢主治的，诽谤在尊位的。
So you find that the their weapons is their words.
所以他们的武器就是他们的话语。
We know that these false teachers are not people from outside the church only.
我们看到这些假师傅或者是假先知，不单只是从教会以外出来。
In reality, many of them actually, they are within the church.
事实上，很多这些假师傅跟假先知都是从教会内出来的。
There is a fundamental question we need to ask here.
所以有一个很基本的问题我们要考虑。
We understand that for anyone who has fully understood the grace of God.
那我们要了解说，那些完全了解神恩典的人
would always give thanks to God even in times of difficulty.
他们在凡事都会感谢神，虽然甚至是遭到困难的时候也会感谢。
Even in times of persecution, you find that the person will continue to give thanks to God.
甚至是遭到逼迫的时候，他们还是持续不断的来感谢神。
Here we find that these people they have changed their nature.
但是我们看到这些人，他们的性情已经改变。
They became grumblers and complainers.
他们是私下议论、常发怨言的人。
Here it says because they walk according to their lusts.
因为这些人是随从自己的情欲而行。
If you read verse 18,
如果我们看第十八节
，and again the last part it says that they would walk according to their own ungodly lusts.
最后一个部分说这些人是随从自己不敬虔的私欲而行。
So when Peter, makes a mention of this, he said the same thing.
所以当彼得提到这些人，他也是说到同样的事情。
I want to read Second Peter chapter 3, verse 3.
你看彼得后书第三章第三节。
Knowing this verse that scoffers will come in the last days, walking according to their own lusts.
必要紧的，该知道在末世必有好讥笑的人，随从自己的私欲出来讥笑说。
From all these passages, we can draw a conclusion.
所以从这些圣经的部分，我们可以得出一个结论。
The false teachers walk according to their lusts.
这些假师傅是随从他们的情欲而行。
We know that Paul talks about fighting against the lust of the flesh.
保罗提到我们要攻克自己的情欲。
For us who are in the church in Christ Jesus.
我们在教会的，在基督耶稣里的信徒。
We are required to constantly battle against our own lusts.
我们要常常来与我们的情欲、肉体的情欲来征战。
That's why the Bible teaches us that we must put to death the lust of the flesh.
所以圣经告诉我们必须要致死身体的恶行。
Quite clearly, the false teachers allow their own lust to dictate their actions.
但是我们看到这些假师傅是让他们的情欲来控制他们的言行举动。
So if we do not cultivate ourselves spiritually.
所以我们在如果没有灵修自己
，you find that when this temptation or falsehood comes.
所以我们当我们遇到这些异端或者是引诱的时候
，not only we can be easily influenced.
我们不单只是很容易受影响。
We find that you know once we are influenced, it becomes difficult for us to come out of the grip of Satan.
我们一受影响的时候，就非常难挣脱这个撒旦的控制。
Because in our daily life, we never cultivate ourselves to put to death the lust of the flesh.
因为我们没有天天灵修自己来致死我们肉体的情欲。
When you look at those who are deceived,
我们看那些被欺骗的人。
You know, many of them have this character problems.
他们许多人都有这个人格上的问题。
They do not emphasize on spiritual cultivation.
他们是不注重个人的灵修。
Now God is giving us time to change ourselves.
现在神给我们这个时候这个时间来改变自己。
So when we see that these things are, you know, are happening.
当我们看到这些事情不断的发生。
It's like a reminder to us.
这就是对我们来说是一个提醒。
That we need to seriously cultivate ourselves.
我们一定要认真的灵修自己。
So in the church, we must demonstrate the nature of Christ.
在教会我们要表现基督的性情。
I want to read the Galatians.
我们请翻开加拉太书。
Please turn to the book of Galatians.
请翻开加拉太书。
In chapter 5, Paul teaches the church to walk in the Spirit.
在加拉太书第五章，保罗教导教会必须要靠圣灵而行。
So must walk in the Spirit so that the church will not fulfill the lust of the flesh.
我们当顺着圣灵而行，就不放纵肉体的情欲了。
I want to read verse 18.
你请看十八节。
Verse 17.
对不起，十七节。
For the flesh lusts against the spirit, and the spirit against the flesh. And these are contrary to one another, so that you do not do the things that you wish.
十七节，因为情欲和圣灵相争，圣灵和情欲相争，这两个是彼此相敌，使你们不能做所愿做的。
And in verse 19, Paul actually lists down very clearly the works of the flesh.
从十九节我们看到保罗一一的提到这个肉体的情欲的各种。
Adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lewdness, idolatry, sorcery, hatred, contentions, jealousy, outbursts of wrath, selfish ambition, dissension, heresies.
所以这里有提到奸淫、污秽、邪荡、拜偶像、邪术、仇恨、争竞、嫉恨、恼怒、结党、纷争、异端、嫉妒、酗酒、荒宴等。
So you find that if we do not get rid of all this wickedness,
如果我们不除掉这些恶行,
our heart become a good place for falsehood to dwell.
那我们的心中就成为这个异端的良田。
Because if we cultivate ourselves,
那如果我们来灵修自己，
we always use the word of God to cleanse ourselves.
我们常常用神的话语来洁净我们自己。
No hatred and no outbursts of anger, you know, no, you know, uncleanness in the heart.
如果我们心中没有仇恨、愤怒，还有嫉妒。
It's difficult for, you know, any form of falsehood to enter into our heart.
啊，这样子这些错误的教训或者是异端就不能进入我们的内心。
So when we read the book of Jews and Jude and Second Peter.
所以我们当我们读这个犹大书和彼得后书的时候，
you find that the false teachers are having these problems in the first place.
啊，这些假师傅就常常在这方面面对的问题。
Because they allow the lust in their hearts to grow. Even to the point of controlling them.
啊，因为他们让这个情欲在他们心中发作，以至于被这个情欲来控制。
So you find that when a person is filled with lust.
啊，所以当一个人的心中充满了这个情欲的时候，
you know, according to Paul.
啊，根据保罗。
Such a person can never learn the word of God.
啊，这等人是没有办法能够明白真理的。
The person may keep on learning the word.
啊，这个人可能不断的要学习神的话。
According to Paul, you know, they can never understand. The person can never understand.
但是根据保罗的说法，这些人是没有办法明白真理的。
Turn to Second Timothy.
请看提摩太后书。
Second Timothy chapter 3.
第三章。
Chapter 3. You read. Verse 6 and verse 7.
第六节和第七节。
Verse 6.
第六节。
And for this sort are those who creep into household and make captives of gullible women, loaded down with sins, led away by various lusts.
第六节，那偷进人家劳碌无知妇女的，正是这等人。这些妇女担负罪恶，被各样的私欲引诱。
Always learning and never able to come to the knowledge of the truth.
第七节，常常学习，终究不能明白真道。
Not only they cannot understand, they would end up actually resisting the truth.
啊，他们不单只是不能明白真道，他们抵挡真道。
We always say we need to stand firm against the work of Satan.
我们常常说，我们要站稳脚步来抵挡这个魔鬼的工作。
To defend our faith.
要捍卫我们的信仰。
Yes, knowing the scriptures is no doubt important.
当然了解圣经是非常的重要。
We realize that cleansing ourselves is even more important.
但是洁净自己是更加的重要。
So if we allow you know, this lust to control us.
如果我们让这个情欲来控制我们的话，
We find that we can easily be influenced by falsehood.
我们就很容易被这异端或者是假的教训来影响。
So here it says that these people walk according to their own ungodly lust.
所以这里提到这些人是随从自己不敬虔的私欲而行。
That's why the Bible says they are mockers.
所以圣经说这些人是讥笑的人。
They despise the word of God.
他们藐视神的话语。
If you look at our life, yeah.
如果我们检讨自己的生活。
We said, you know, these people, they show no respect to the gospel of salvation.
你说这些人是对这个得救的福音是没有任何的尊重。
Because they never, you know, honor the doctrines that they have received.
因为他不尊重他所领受的这个得救的教义。
If we look at ourselves.
那如果我们检讨自己。
There are many teachings that we need to apply, you know, in our life.
我们知道在我们的生活当中，我们要将各种的圣经的经训来实行出来。
We always talk about Christian living.
我们常常说基督徒的生活。
Meaning applying the word of God into good use or into practice.
就是将
the word of God into practice.
就是将神的话语在我们生活当中实践出来。
More often than not, we find that we don't normally do that.
但是我们常常发现到我们都没有这样做。
That in itself is a form of rebellion.
这样做的话就是一种悖逆的行为。
So we always rebel against God.
因为这样我们就是常常悖逆神的。
When this happens, you find that, you know, lust will begin to grow in the heart.
那如果我们常常这样做的话，情欲就会在我们心中来生长。
Now, so when falsehood comes.
所以当这个异端来的时候，
you can imagine who can stand against this falsehood.
那你可以设想一下，有任何人能够在异端的面前站得住吗？
Because in our daily life, we never respect God.
因为我们在每一天的生活当中都没有尊重神。
We don't do the word of the Lord.
我们没有将神的话语行出来。
We will not be given this ability to discern.
我们到这个时候就没有这个能力，神就不会赐予我们这个能力来分辨。
Because in the first place, we never respect God.
因为从起初我们就不尊重神。
That's why we have to learn to honor and to respect God in our daily life.
所以我们要学习在每一天的日常生活当中来尊荣神。
In this way, we will not be easily influenced by falsehood.
这样子的话，我们就不容易被这个异端来影响。
Now we also see that in the book of Jude, Jude mentions about Enoch.
这犹大书里面，犹大也提到有关以诺的事情。
I'm going to read the verse 15 first.
我们先看十五节。
The last part it says, and of all the harsh things which ungodly sinners have spoken against him.
又证实不敬虔之罪人所说顶撞他的刚愎话。
It seems to me that, you know, these sinners are speaking against God.
所以好像这些人其实就是顶撞神。
Now, here Enoch is mentioned.
这里提到有关以诺。
Some people said, you know, verse 14 and verse 15 actually is like a quotation from one of the books of in the Apocrypha.
有些人说第十四节、十五节是这个旁经里面的一段经文。
That is a quotation from the book of Enoch.
就是这个旁经里面这个以诺这本书信里面的一段。
That's why some people say we also need to accept, we have to accept Apocrypha as authentic scriptures as well.
所以有些人认为说，因为因此这样，我们也要接受这个旁经其实都是圣经的一部分。
We need to understand that even though this may be similar to the book of Enoch.
但是我们要了解，虽然这段讲的事情跟那个旁经里面以诺书里面所讲的事情是相似的。
There is no way to prove that, you know, Jude has copied them from the book of Enoch.
但是我们没有办法证明说犹大是抄这个以诺书里面所写的。
On top of that, you know, not all the books in the book in this apocrypha are not accurate.
而且我们发现到这个旁经里面的有一些书信是不准确的。
Not all of them are inaccurate.
他们不是所有的都是准确的。
So the point I'm making is this.
我要提到的重点就是。
We cannot use these two verses to confirm that the apocrypha is acceptable.
我的重点就是你不能用这两节经文来证实说旁经是真实的经文。
Right? Now we look at verse 14.
我们看十四节。
Here it says the seven from Adam prophesies about this man also.
亚当的七世孙以诺曾经预言这些人。
Behold, the Lord comes with 10,000s of his saints.
看啊，主带着他千万圣者降临。
To execute judgment on all, to convict all who are ungodly among them of all their ungodly deeds which they have committed in an ungodly way, and of all the harsh things which ungodly sinners have spoken against him.
十五节要众人身上行审判，证实那一切不敬虔的人所妄行一切不敬虔的事，又证实不敬虔之罪人所说顶撞他的刚愎话。
Judging from the contents of these two verses,
那如果我们看这两节的内容，
it's quite clear that Enoch is talking about what will happen in the end time.
以诺所提的就是在末世所要发生的事情。
So, you know, God would come, you know, with 10,000 of his saints to judge.
这个主会带着他千万的圣者来审判世人，众人。
To convict, you know, the ungodly people of their ungodly deeds and words.
要审判他们，证实他们不敬虔的行为和不敬虔的话语。
So, you know, Enoch was given this understanding long time ago.
所以以诺很老早已经被神启示要发生这样的事情。
Now the main point here is about judging those who speak against God or those who go against God.
那重点就是神要审判那些背逆神的说不敬虔话语的人的。
So from here we can see that when you look at the book of Jude.
所以我们看从这里看到，如果我们看犹大书。
We have example before the flood.
我们有这个洪水之前的例子。
We have Old Testament examples.
我们有提到这个旧约时代，旧约圣经时代的这个例子。
We also can see example, in the church, when Jude was.
也有提到犹大他们那时候教会的一些例子。
So you find that this fighting against falsehood is something that we have to be aware of and has to really do it well.
所以我们要非常谨慎来捍卫真理，要做得很好。
Now here, you know, Enoch was able to do this.
我们看到以诺
able to prophesy.
以诺能够说这个预言
meaning that he must have been given understanding.
就是说神另给他这个明白。
Now we need to ask a very important question.
所以我们要问自己一个很重要的问题。
Why did God give him this prophecy?
神为什么要启示以诺这个预言呢？
You know, in the ancient times, obviously, God, you know, give them prophecies to prophesy, you know, so that we can learn about their prophecies.
我们知道在古代神给先知这些预言让我们这个后代的人来学习。
Many a time, you know, the prophecies given to them are not for themselves, but for us today.
常常这些预言不是给当代的信徒，而是给我们末世的信徒。
We can say that,This Enoch has been given understanding.
我们可以断定说以诺被神启示这个预言。
What was so special about Enoch?
那以诺有什么特别呢？
I want you to turn to Genesis.
我们请翻开这个创世纪。
Genesis, we read chapter 5.
创世纪第五章。
Genesis chapter 5.
创世纪第五章。
You read verse 22.
二十二节。
Genesis chapter 5, verse 22.
创世纪五章二十二节。
After he begot Methuselah, Enoch walked with God 300 years and had sons and daughters.
二十二节，以诺生马土撒拉之后，与神同行三百年，并且生儿养女。
Genesis chapter 5 talks about the family of Adam.
这个创世纪第五章是亚当后代的这个家谱。
It's the book of genealogy.
它是讲到他们的家谱。
So find that, you know, the cycle mentioned in this chapter is, you know, the who will beget who.
就是说某某人活到几岁就生了什么人。
And how long, you know, the person would live.
然后这个人活了几岁。
And then he died.
然后他就去世了。
And then the next generation continued the cycle.
然后下一代这个事情又不断的重复。
In this genealogy, there is a special person. That's Enoch.
这个在这个族谱里面有个很特别人就是以诺。
Because he walked with God.
因为他与神同行。
Something that is not mentioned in any other you know, persons here in chapter 5.
所以第五章没有任何人与神同行，就只是单单是以诺这个。
Now a way to read verse 24.
我们看24节。
And Enoch walked with God, and he was not, for God took him.
24节，以诺与神同行，神将他取去，他就不在世了。
So there is a difference between Enoch and the others.
所以以诺与其他家谱里面的人是有区别的。
We said the conclusion is different.
他们的结局是不一样的。
We know Enoch was translated, was lifted up to heaven.
我们知道以诺被神取去了，被提到天上去了。
And whereas all the other people died.
那所有其他人都死了。
What is the teaching here that we can gather?
那从这里我们可以学习到什么重要的教训呢？
So you find that when we walk with God,
所以我们发现到当我们与神同行的话
we can escape death.
我们就可以脱离死亡。
According to the book of Genesis,
根据这个创世纪
you find that, you know, death is the result of sin. Man dies because God cursed a man.
我们知道一个人会死是因为罪的缘故。一个人会死因为他犯罪受了神的咒诅。
So, you know, death is a kind of cursed.
所以死亡就是一种咒诅。
For Enoch who followed God, walked with God.
但是以诺却是与神同行。
We find that this curse has no effect or power over him.
但是因为他与神同行，所以这个咒诅在他身上不会发生任何的功效。
For us today who believe in Jesus.
对我们今天相信耶稣的人来说。
If we are truly saved.
如果我们真的得救了
so on the day that we depart from this world,
当我们离世的那一天
according to the Bible, we merely have fallen asleep.
根据圣经的说法，我们是单单是在主里睡了。
You find that when this Stephen was stoned to death,
当斯提凡被人用石头打死的时候
the Bible says he fell asleep.
圣经说他就睡了。
We turn to chapter 7, Acts of the Apostle, chapter 7.
我们请翻开《使徒行传》第七章。
Acts chapter 7, we read verse 60.
《使徒行传》第七章六十节。
Then he knelt down and cried out with a loud voice, Lord, do not charge them with this sin. And when he had said this, he fell asleep.
六十节又跪下，大声喊着说，主啊，不要将这罪归于他们。说了这话就睡了。
So meaning that, you know, in the eyes of God, he was merely asleep.
换句话说，当他肉身死的时候，在神的眼中，他只是睡了。
Because he's going to rise again, and you know he will be raised to life and unto eternity.
因为有一天他将会复活，被神提升到天国去享受永生。
That's why those who believe in Jesus.
所以那些凡信耶稣的人
，those who die in the Lord is a blessing.
那些在主里死去的人都是蒙福的。
Because all his work shall follow.
Because his work will follow him.
So you find that Enoch was very different. He was able to escape death.
他能够脱离这个死亡,
because the Bible says he walked with God.
因为圣经说他是与神同行的。
Today, if we want to gain understanding from the Lord,
所以今天如果我们要从神那里来得到这个明白。
Today we have the Holy Spirit in our hearts.
今天我们有圣灵在我们心中。
So for the Spirit to teach us,
如果我们要让圣灵来教导我们，
we have to walk with God.
我们一定要与神同行。
Now, what does it mean to walk with God?
与神同行是什么意思呢？
You know, Genesis does not mention much about the meaning or the essence of walking with God.
这个创世纪没有很清楚的提到与神同行的这个精神是什么。
But we can look at this Noah.
但是我们可以看这个挪亚的例子。
Because he is also someone who walked with God.
因为他也是一个与神同行的一个人。
I want to read chapter 6, Genesis chapter 6.
我们请翻开创世纪第六章。
Verse 9.
第九节。
Genesis chapter 6 verse 9.
创世纪六章九节。
This is the genealogy of Noah. Noah was a just man, perfect in his generation. Noah walked with God.
第九节，挪亚的后代记在下面。挪亚是个义人，在当时的世代是个完全人。挪亚与神同行。
You find that, you know, the chapters are given to describe of Noah is much longer.
所以我们看到这个形容这个记载挪亚事迹的这个经文比较长。
So you find that there are two points when we talk about Noah walking with God.
所以这个挪亚与神同行其实是有两点。
The first is he distinguished himself from the world.
第一是他与世人有这个区别。
That's why he found grace in God's eyes.
所以他在神的面前蒙恩。
The second thing is he followed every instruction that God has given to him.
第二点就是他是完全照着神所有的吩咐来行。
So when we put these two points together,
当我们将这两点合起来，
then we can understand the meaning of walking with God.
这样子我们就能够明白什么叫做与神同行。
So today if we say we walk with God,
所以今天如果我们说我们是与神同行的，
we must distinguish ourselves from the world.
我们一定要有与世界来区别。
The world is not of God.
这个世界是不是属神的。
So if we do not detach ourselves from the world,
如果我们不与世界来脱离，
we follow the things of the world,
我们随着世界世俗来行走，
we do the things of the world,
我们做世人所做的事情，
then we can never walk with God.
这样子我们就不可能与神同行。
So this is the first point. Yeah, we must, you know, distinguish ourselves.
这个是第一点，我们要与世界区别的地方。
The second is to follow God's way.
第二个就是照着神的道路来行。
You find that because this Noah, you know, distinguish himself.
啊，因为挪亚他与世人有这个区别。
That's why God asked him to build an ark, and God said to him that he would want to destroy the world.
啊，所以神就吩咐挪亚来造这个方舟，因为神要来毁灭这个世界。
So with this understanding, we can look at Enoch as well.
啊，从这点我们也可以来看这个以诺这个。
And we understand why God has given him prophecies.
我们也能够了解为什么神将这个预言启示给这个以诺。
So that he would prophesy concerning the end of time.
啊，这样子他就预言这个末世的事情。
You find that when a person is close to God.
我们发现到，当一个人与神非常的亲近的时候
，so he really care much about the matters of God.
啊，他所关心的都是神的事情。
The things concerning the church.
啊，关心教会的事情。
Because his heart is close to God.
啊，因为他的心与神非常的靠近。
You find that when this happens, God will give him a lot of spiritual eyesight, foresight.
啊，这样子的话，神就会给他这个独特的属灵的远见跟远光。
He can see things that others may not be able to see.
他们能够看透那些其他人不能够看透的事情。
He may be able to understand things that others cannot understand.
他们能够明白其他人不能够明白的事情。
And he can detect a danger very clearly.
他非常的明确的能够发觉到这个危险的地方。
Because he is close to God.
因为他与神亲近。
So today, if you want to fight against falsehood.
今天我们如果要与这个异端来征战。
Again, to be well versed with the scriptures is no doubt essential.
当然我们必须要熟悉圣经。
So our heart must be close to God.
但是我们的心也要非常靠近主。
We must connect to God.
我们要与神来连接。
To do that, we must walk with Him.
如果我们要这样与神靠近的话，我们必须要与神来同行。
So if we are close to God, we are given understanding, then obviously we will not easily fall into temptation or falsehood.
如果我们跟神非常靠近，神给我们这个智慧的话，我们就不容易被这个异端来影响。
Not only we will not be affected.
我们不单只是不受影响。
We'll be able to defend and speak out against falsehood.
这样子我们能够捍卫真理，也能够抵挡这个异端。
That's why Enoch, you find that he was given the prophecies to talk about how these ungodly sinners will speak against God.
所以因为以诺是这样的一个人，所以神就启示他这个预言末世这些不敬虔的人所说的话。
Some of the ungodly words may not be going against any particular person.
他们说不敬虔的话，可能不是攻击某一个人。
Sometimes you find that these words go against the principle of God.
但是他们所说的话是违反了神的原则。
Or change the principle of God.
或者他们所说的话是更改了神的原则。
So how can we detect?
那如果是这样的话，我们如何能够发觉呢？
When we are close to God, then obviously we can detect.
那如果我们亲近神的话，我们就很容易发觉到问题。
Let me give you a very simple example.
我给你一个很简单的例子。
It's okay. When someone speaks something different, let's say, to what we used to believe.
当一个人讲传讲一些与我们的传统的信仰有不同的地方的道理。
Some people might say it's okay. Everyone is entitled to his opinion.
那我们说没有关系了，每个人都有话语权来发表自己的意见。
This is his understanding.
这是他的理解。
So obviously, he can speak what he wants to speak.
当然他有权利来说他要来发表他的自己的意见。
You find that this understanding, this concept is like, harmless.
你可能认为这样的一个观念其实是不会对人产生什么伤害的。
Because after all, This is only a concept.
你觉得这只是他个人的观念而已。
And also the world teaches us that it's okay, you know, for everyone to speak, to speak out their mind, to speak what they want.
而且世界也不是教导我们每个人都有发言权，我们必须勇于发表自己的意见吗？
But we know that this is not right.
但是我们知道这是不对的。
Because this is the church of God.
因为我们现在是在神的教会里面。
So the church of God, you know, we follow God's way.
在教会里面，我们是追随神的方法。
There is only one set of principle.
在教会只有一套的这个原则。
There is only one standard in the church.
在教会只有一个标准。
Sometimes we hear people say,
我们可能有听一些人这样说。
Do you believe that TJC is the only true church?
他们可能问你说，你是否相信耶稣教会是唯一得救的教会呢？
I'm being honest with you. This question is being raised all the time.
我现在对你很诚实的说，这个问题常常在教会被发问。
Only recently I heard, you know, some people ask these questions.
最近我又听到有些人起这样的这个疑问。
You know, they go to different places, they ask different people about, you know, their opinion concerning the true church.
你发现到不同的地方，他们会问。来访当地的这些工人有关这件事情的他们的观念。
It becomes so common now.
现在非常的普遍了。
We know that this is not normal.
我们知道这是不正常的现象。
So if we are not serious about our belief,
那如果我们对我们的信仰不是很认真的话，
we're not close to God, connected to Him.
我们不亲近神，我们不跟神连接。
We won't think that this is very serious.
我们不会认为这是非常严重的问题。
Actually, this is a very serious matter because it challenges our core belief.
其实这个是一个非常严重的问题，因为这是直接挑战我们的中心的信仰。
We only have one body.
我们只有一个身体。
We know that there's only one church.
我们知道只有一个教会。
And also the Holy Spirit has confirmed to us that this is the only body of Christ.
圣灵也证实给我们知道这是他唯一的身体。
But to many people, you know, this kind of belief is okay. You know, we can tolerate.
但是有些人说没有关系，我们能够接纳这样的意见。
To me, this is like a kind of yeast in the church.
对我来说，这是教会里面有发酵的作用。
It's only a matter of time that, you know, if we are not careful, we can be livened up by this yeast.
如果我们不警觉的话，我们就会被这个酵所影响。
So we have to distinguish ourselves from the world.
所以我们要与世界来区别。
The world does not necessarily refer only to, you know, things outside the church.
所以世界不单单是指教会外的事情。
Anything that is against the principle of God is of the world.
凡是抵触神的原则的事情都是属世的。
Against the truth of God is of the world.
凡是抵触神的真理都是属世的。
So if we are close to God,
那如果你亲近神的话，
then we believe that God will give us this understanding.
那我们相信神
this discerning power
会给我们这个分辨的能力，这个智慧。
To see through the work of Satan.
能够看透撒旦的工作。
In this way, we will not fall prey to a falsehood.
这样子我们就不会被这个异端所影响。
We sing.
我们请唱诗。
158
首。